हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 2 ऑफ ज्योग्राफी। द नेम ऑफ चैप्टर इज लैंड फॉर्म्स। इन द चैप्टर 2 द की कॉन्सेप्ट आर टाइप्स ऑफ लैंड फॉर्म्स, माउंटेन्स वैलीज, प्लेट्यू, प्लेन्स, लैंड फॉर्म एंड पीपल्स। एंड थीम 2 ऑल्सो ऑफ द लर्निंग कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ऑल्सो इज this identify different type of landform etc. So in today's class we are going to start our first topic is landform. So let's start landforms. A landform is a natural feature of the solid surface of the earth or any other planetary body. The landform is a type of natural feature, the main natural feature of a solid surface like of a land or a planetary body, means of a plane. Landform includes mountains, hills, plateaus, plains, canyons, gorges, valley, bays, gulfs, sea, peninsulas, ridges, volcanoes and the great ocean basin. So that's all are the that come into land forms. Let's study about formation of land forms, endogenous and exogenous processes, means how land forms built or formed. Landforms are produced by the earth's natural forces of erosion, deposition and tectonic processes, means erosion of means of soil erodes from one place to other, deposition, collection of soil rocks on one another, and tectonic processes like of an earthquake. Both endogenetic and exogenetic. The scientific study of these processes that shapes landforms are called geomorphology. Geo means earth, morpho means form, and ology means study of earth form. The landform mainly formed on the surface of the earth. Landforms mainly formed on the earth surface caused by the forces which are divided into two category. That forms due to two forces, that are endogenic or internal forces, exogenic or external forces. Endogenic means the internal forces interior of the earth, and exogenic that are external forces that are due to external factors. So the internal forces of earth are responsible for the formation of various type of landforms. Because of internal forces, many landforms are formed on the earth. That is why they are called constructive forces or endogenic forces. Internal forces are also called constructive forces and endogenic forces. Folding and faulting of the earth's surface are done because of the internal forces. Folding and faulting is totally dependent on internal forces. But the external forces have the tendency to convert the surface of the earth into a plane surface by removing irregularities. Means these forces are called destructive or exogenic forces because they cause widespread destruction through weathering and erosion. It's destruct through weathering and erosion. these forces are of wind, water, rain and glacier. Glacier means ice, the mountain of ice, etc. These are also called agents of weathering. They are called the agents of the weathering, means wind, water, rain and glaciers. Let's study about endogenic forces or internal forces. The forces operating inside the earth are called the endogenic forces. They are also known as the tectonic movements. This movement is divided into two parts: diastrophic forces and sudden forces. First is diastrophic forces and second is sudden forces. Let's summarize or study through the help of some example. A horizontal body or sedimentary rocks, a simple plain surface. Forces of compression from left side and forces of compression from right side. What happened to that horizontal bedded sedimentary rocks? It converted in a curved shape. The below curve is called the syncline and the above one is called the anticline. Syncline stand up as mountain and the syncline they stand up like a mountains, up as a mountains. Now the figure shows the faulting of rocks. The cracking is called the faulting of rocks. First is diastrophic forces. The diastrophic forces include horizontal movement and vertical movement. The horizontal and vertical movement comes under diastrophic forces. First, horizontal movement. Horizontal movements are caused by the forces beneath the earth, below the earth. These movements are also known as the orogenic or mountain building movement. This is because of that force mountains are built. These movements generally occurs horizontally on the earth surface. That's occur horizontally on the surface and mainly disturb the horizontal layer of the earth's crust. That is why these movements are complex in nature, very rigid in nature. These movements work in two ways. First, in the opposite direction and second, towards each other. These are called compressional and tensional force. Compressional and tensional forces. Horizontal forces are slow. That horizontal forces are very slow and their effects are visible after a long time. And their effects we can say after a very long time. Tensional forces leads to fractures, cracks and faulting of rocks. Because of tensional forces, the fracture, cracks and faulting of rocks take place. And the compressional forces led to the crumbling and folding of rocks. The fold rocks because of compressions. So let's study about vertical movements. The vertical movements are also known as the epigeogenic or continent building. Epigeogenic means a continent. If a continent is a part of land surrounded by water. These movements cause rise and fall of the portion of the earth. Because of this movement, the portion of may be rise or fall. These movements are the result in internal forces acting radically from the center of the earth. It is done from the center of the earth. These movements are responsible for the formation of block mountains and rift valleys. These movements are powerful as they could cause rise of extensive areas such as continents. See the figure. The upliftment made a mountain and subsidence and depletion. Upliftment and subsidence shows in the figure. The raised portion are known as the uplift and the downward portion are known as the subsidence. That downward portion is called the subsidence. Now our next point is sudden forces. What is sudden forces? Movements mainly caused by sudden endogenic forces coming from deep, मतलब below the earth, beyond the earth, within the earth, cause sudden and rapid events that cause massive destruction, massive destruction at and below the surface of the earth, on the surface of the earth and below the surface of the earth, that sudden forces destruction occurs. Volcanic eruption and earthquake are called extreme events. Volcanic eruption and earthquakes are called our extreme events. When they occur in densely populated regions, they become dangerous, very dangerous, because they kill many more peoples. That figure shows the extreme natural event create certain relief features on the earth's surface, the melting of that glacier, and become dangerous hazards earthquake and volcanic eruptions become very hazardous. Graphically, these sudden forces are termed as constructive forces because they create certain relief features as mountain, plateau and plains on the earth's surface. This also called the constructive, because it also constructs some things like mountains, plateau and plains on the earth's surface. That's why these sudden forces are also called constructive forces. So student, that's all from this class. In our next class, we are going to study about exogenic forces or external forces. Thank you.